Namaste. Today, let's explore the Surya Namaskar in all of its parts. Let's start by opening up our body by waving our arms back and forth. Just really feel the chest and the back opening. Swing side to side. Just feel the body starting to open. Nothing here too difficult. Just open up the body. Now, swing your hands back and forth, up and over your head. Just allow the body to pivot at the shoulders. You're just swinging your arms up and down with the breath, inhaling as you come up, exhaling as you go down. Start to move the body side to side, opening up the hips, swaying, feeling fully open. We're preparing ourselves, warming ourselves up to start our practice this morning. Let's go into our Brahma Mudra by inhaling and dropping our head back, exhaling and dropping our chin forward. Inhaling back, exhaling forward. One more time. Inhaling, really open up through the neck. Exhaling, dropping the chin to the chest. Inhaling, coming back to center and exhaling to the right. Inhaling back to center, exhaling to the left. Inhaling, exhaling to the right. Inhaling, exhaling to the left. Inhaling back to center, exhaling to the right and hold. Inhaling back to center, exhaling left and hold. Inhaling back to normal position, dropping our head to the right. Inhaling back to center, dropping our head to the left. Inhaling, exhaling to the right. Inhaling, exhaling to the left. Inhaling, exhale, drop and hold. Inhaling, exhale, drop and hold. Inhaling back to the center. Exhaling, dropping our chin to the chest and rolling our head around with the exhalation. Inhaling deeply, exhaling in the opposite direction, anti-clockwise. Inhaling, exhaling, rolling clockwise, opening up all parts of the neck. Again, exhaling, anti-clockwise, opening up all parts of the neck. One more time in each direction. Feeling fully open and free, opening ourselves fully through this Brahma Mudra. Four different steps, yes, no, maybe, now. Releasing all the tension in our body, waving it all out, and coming to stand in our Samasthiti. Samasthiti, this is our strong primary posture. We're rolling our shoulders back. We're opening up from the toes all the way up through the top of the head. We are actually engaging each and every muscle in our body, all the way from the toes, engaging through the ankles, the knees, pushing the hips forward, pulling the shoulders back, chin parallel to the ground. We can take a couple of nice, long, deep breaths with our eyes open or closed, and then bringing our hands in the namaste at the heart, dropping our chin down towards our chest, connecting with our heart center, breathing deeply, preparing ourselves for our morning or afternoon practice. A couple more deep breaths, connecting to the heart center. Inhaling, bringing the hands up and over the head. We're looking up towards the hands now. We're looking up towards our hands, opening up through the neck, pulling our shoulder blades together, opening up through the chest and breathing. This is Parvatasana, our mountain pose. Dropping one hand down, looking up towards the bicep and then past the bicep, Ardha Chakrasana. We're looking all the way up towards the ceiling, past our bicep, opening through the side, feeling a strong side opening. Inhaling, bringing our hands back up, looking back down, and looking up again. Dropping our right hand down, extending the left, looking up towards our bicep, pushing our hips forward, allowing the body to be in one flat plane. We're looking up towards the ceiling. A couple more breaths here. comfortably breathing, inhaling back up to Parvatasana, looking down towards our toes once again, looking back up towards our fingertips, and twisting around to the left side, pushing back on our left shoulder with our right hand, opening up through the chest. We're looking over our shoulder, Ardhakati Chakrasana. We're just breathing here, allowing our body to fully open up. Pull that left shoulder back a little bit further. Inhaling, coming up into our Parvatasana and twisting to the other direction, placing our left hand on our right shoulder, pushing back on the shoulder, twisting through the torso, using the right hand on the lower back to push our back forward so that our pelvis is in line with the mat. We're only twisting through the torso. Inhaling, coming back up to our Parvatasana. A couple deep breaths here. Dropping our shoulders once again, keeping that space. Intertwining and inverting our fingers. Palms towards the ceiling. You're looking up past your fingers. Exhaling, bringing your hands down towards the chest. And coming back to our Samasthiti. Preparing ourselves a little further for our first Surya Namaskar round by first opening up the chest. Let's open up our chest and then drop down forward. We're staying only halfway down here. We're going to place our hands on our elbows and swing side to side. Gently at first, we're just swinging side to side, really starting to let our body open up. We've not really started the practice yet now. We're still just opening up the body, extending our fingers to the ground, and vertebrae by vertebrae, very slowly, we're coming back up to a standing position, feeling all parts of our neck, back, opening through the chest, and releasing. Good. Now we're starting to feel that even we have inverted a little bit, we're feeling comfortable, we're feeling calm, we're opening up our body to our Shitali Tadasana, feet shoulder width apart, hands open, breathing. A couple deep breaths here. Opening our eyes and coming to the front of the mat. Preparing ourselves mentally to start our first Surya Namaskar. Bringing our hands to Namaste at the heart. Inhaling, bringing our hands up and above the head. We're looking over the hands, exhaling. We're dropping down towards our forward bend, placing the fingertips on the ground. Inhaling, dropping the right knee down. Inhaling, looking up into the sky. Exhaling, coming to a plank, flat as a board. Inhaling, exhaling, Shashtang Namaskarasana, forehead on the ground. Inhaling, coming up into our Bhujangasana. Exhaling, into our downward facing dog. In our downward facing dog to our Vanarasana. Right foot has come back forward, looking up. Exhaling, dropping into a forward bend. Inhaling, watching our hands up and over the head, arching back. Exhaling, back into our forward bend again. Inhaling, bringing our left foot back, looking up towards the sky. Exhaling, into our plank. Inhaling, exhaling, into Shastang Namaskarasana, buttocks off the ground. Inhaling, looking up in our Bhujangasana. Exhaling, into our Adho Mukha Svanasana, downward facing dog. Inhaling, back to Vanarasana. Exhaling, coming into our Uttanasana, our forward bend. Inhaling, bringing the hands up and over the head, arching back. Exhaling, back to Namaste. One round of our Surya Namaskar is finished. Just allowing ourselves to adjust out, get comfortable, work out any little bit of kinks. We can rotate our body back and forth. Just allow any of those little kinks in the muscles or in the bones, any gas, just release all of that. You can even throw your hands up and over the head a few times. We're just really opening up our body at this time. Balance on your feet, whatever feels good to you right now, just allow any of that stress to get out of the body and come back to the front of the mat for our next Surya Namaskar. Inhaling, watching your hands as they go back, exhaling into our forward bend. We're coming into our forward bend. Inhaling, bringing your right foot down to the ground, looking up into our Vanarasana. Exhaling into our plank. Inhaling, exhaling into our Shastang Namaskar. Inhaling, looking up. Exhaling, coming into our downward facing dog. Inhaling into Vanarasana. Exhaling into our forward bend. Inhaling, bringing our hands up and over the head. Exhaling, coming down into a forward bend once again. Our fourth Surya Namaskar. Our left knee is on the ground, and then we're coming into our plank pose. Coming down into our Shastang Namaskar with an inhale and exhale. Inhale, looking up towards the sky. Exhale, into our downward facing dog. Inhale, left foot comes forward into our Vanarasana. Exhale into our forward bend, Uttanasana. Inhaling up into Ardha Chakrasana. Exhaling and falling forward once again. Inhaling, coming back into our Vanarasana, our fifth round. Into our plank pose, Shastang Namaskar. Coming up into our Bhujangasana. We're really warming up the body now, feeling comfortable in the poses. We're getting comfortable with the actual Surya Namaskar itself. Before we explore all the different aspects of our Surya Namaskar, we're finishing up our fifth Surya Namaskar and moving into our sixth. You're comfortable with the Surya Namaskar now. This is our sixth round. We're moving from our plank down into our Shastang Namaskar, which is an inhale, exhale. Inhaling, coming back up into our Bhujangasana. Exhaling, Adho Mukha Svanasana. Inhaling, left foot forward into our Vanarasana. Exhaling, right foot forward into our Uttanasana. Inhaling, bringing the hands up and over to the head, Ardha Chakrasana. And hands into Namaste, Namaskar. At the chest, and move your body around. Okay, we've done six rounds of our Surya Namaskar. Our body is now nicely warmed up. And now we'll begin practicing different aspects of the Surya Namaskar in detail, exploring different asanas in different ways. So we're just rolling our shoulders back and bringing our hands in a namaste. We're going to inhale, opening up our chest. Exhale, falling into a forward bend, bringing our fingertips to the ground. And inhale, bringing both feet back into our Adho Mukha Svanasana. We're just taking a moment to explore the inversion, to invert our head. We've been coming up and down so many times in our six rounds of our Surya Namaskar. Now we're just taking a few moments in our inversion to allow the body to redistribute the blood into our feet, into our heads. We're trying to bring our heels towards the ground. We're pushing all the way through our hands, but we're not clenching the shoulders. We're opening the shoulders. Hips are going up into the sky, pushing the heels a little further into the ground. And now coming onto our knees. Toes are tucked underneath. We are coming into our child's pose, Balasana. Child's pose A. Our elbows are on the ground. Palms are flat against the ground. We're dropping our hips down towards our ankles and just resting here, breathing deeply, resting here in child's pose, allowing any little bit of tension that has been built up during the last 14 or 15 minutes just to fade away. We're here comfortably in our child's pose, forehead lightly touching the ground. A few more deep breaths, just allowing any little bit of tension to go away. Walking our fingertips back towards our body, bringing our fingers into our chin mudra, placing them on the thighs. Keeping our eyes closed, we're breathing very deeply in our Vajrasana, our thunderbolt, our hero's pose. Breathing deeply and coming back down into our Balasana for a couple more deep breaths. Coming into our Adho Mukha Svanasana for a few deep breaths. We're coming back out of our relaxation, moving our fingertips back towards our feet. We're in our forward bend now. We're in our uttanasana. We're in our forward bend. And again, vertebrae by vertebrae, we're coming up and up and up, releasing a chest opening and coming back towards the front of the mat, midway to the front of the mat, creating a strong foundation, placing the hands on the lower back. We're supporting our lower back as we open up the chest, dropping our chin back. We're in a simplified Ardha Chakrasana. We're like a half wheel. We're breathing here. We're really opening up our back through this back bend. Inhale, coming back up. Exhale, falling forward into our forward bend. Halfway down. Let's not drop all the way down yet. Halfway down, let's pause. And only after we've paused for a breath or two, we're dropping our fingertips to the ground. We're waving our hands back and forth. We're just really opening up the body now. The body is fully warmed up. We've had the chance to go through numerous Surya Namaskar. Again, one more time, vertebrae by vertebrae, we're coming back up, opening up the chest a little bit, and coming back to our hands on the hips. Once again, opening up through the chest, dropping our chin back, exhaling, coming forward into our tabletop. Our back is flat now, we're looking towards the wall. We're creating a strong foundation with our feet. We're bringing the shoulder blades together. Our chin is still up. We're looking towards the wall. We're preparing ourselves to go into a forward bend with a flat back. Fingertips, hands, trying to touch the feet and best to bring the toes, the big toe, into the cradle of the hand. Keeping the back flat, opening through the hamstrings. We're coming down and starting to pedal our knees. We're pedaling our knees in our Paddha Angustasana. Pedaling our knees. We can pedal our knees 5 to 10 times. We're just helping the hamstrings to open up fully. Back and forth, pedaling our knees, trying not to move the hips. We're trying to move the hips as least as possible. This will allow for a really good opening in the hips. Tucking forward again, releasing the hands, placing the hands back on the hips, inhaling, coming back to a tabletop, a flat back. We're looking towards the wall. Our chin is still up. Inhaling, coming up, dropping back, exhaling, coming back to a standing position. We've come back to a standing position. Let's just rotate our body back and forth, left to right. We're just allowing the body to fully open up here. Whatever you need to open up the body, this is the time to do it. Come back towards the front of the mat. Bring the feet together, coming back into a strong Samasthiti. Let's come back into a strong Samasthiti. Really open up the chest, roll the shoulders open, roll the chest open. 2 or 3 times, we're rolling the chest open. A strong Samasthiti. A strong Samasthiti. Bring your hands to Namaste. Inhale, exhale. Inhale, bring the hands up into the sky. Exhale, we're falling forward. We're falling forward, bringing our hands down towards the ground. Bringing the right foot back. Pushing the left hip down. Inhaling and looking up. Place your hands on the lower back and press down. Press down, really opening up through the hips. For the next few minutes, we're going to focus on opening up through the hips. So let's explore the hips a little bit through a couple of very comfortable but also strong asana. We've placed our hands inside of our legs now, brought the left leg out to the outside, interconnected our fingers, and now pushed our hips down towards the ground. You should feel a real opening through the hips here. The hips are very open. Now, placing our hands back on the ground, we're going to work our left foot across the mat. We're coming into a Rajkapotasana, our pigeon pose. If we can come down a little deeper, we're trying to come down onto our elbows. Again, our left leg is going underneath our chest, coming down even a little deeper if you can, trying to lay the chest directly on top of the leg. This was preparing ourselves for a full Rajkapotasana, our king pigeon pose. We're really opening up through the chest here. We're opening up through the hips here. We're allowing our whole body to relax for a couple of moments. Inhaling, coming back onto our elbows, fingers intertwined, breathing deeply, placing our hands back on the mat. We're going to work our foot back over through the mat to the left side of the mat. Come back onto our elbows, fingers intertwined. We're finishing up our hip opening here on the left side, bringing our hands back to the center of the mat. Left hand on the outside of the left foot, looking back up again in our Vanarasana, placing our hands on the lower hips, pushing down like a split, placing our hands back on the sides and coming back into our plank. Really, I've opened the hips, especially to the left side now. Let's go on and work our way through the Surya Namaskar into our Ashtanga Namaskar. Inhaling, Bhujangasana. Exhaling, Adho Mukha Svanasana. Let's stay here for a couple of moments, a couple of breaths. In our Adho Mukha, really pressing your heels down towards the ground, pelvis being pulled up into the sky as if a rope is pulling you forward and up. Up and up and up. We're bringing our chest further and further towards the ground, opening up through the shoulders. Long, deep breaths. Inhaling and bringing our right foot back forward into our Vanarasana. Placing our hands on the hips. Now we're doing the same thing on the other side. We're pushing down into the split. We're going to now bring our right hand on the inside of the right leg. So the right leg comes out. Breathing here. Coming down onto our elbows, intertwining the fingers, really pressing the pelvis towards the ground. Long deep breaths. The right leg is on the outside of the mat. You're fully opening through the pelvis. Deep breaths. Long deep breaths. Placing our hands at the front of the mat and working our right foot through the mat to the left side. We're going to be laying over that right leg first on our elbows. We're breathing. We're breathing long deep breaths. If we feel comfortable, we can try to lay our chest all the way on the ground, forehead on the ground. We're laying directly over our right leg now. Long, deep breaths. You'll feel a real opening through the entire hips and upper leg section. Breathe. Breathe. And whenever you're ready, you bring your right hand and then left hand back together, intertwine the fingers, elbows on the mat, long deep breaths. We're coming back the same way we came in. A really wonderful hip opening exercise that you can do any day, especially before you're gonna sit for a long amount of time. We've brought both hands back into the center. The right hand goes on the outside of the right foot, looking up. Coming back into our forward bend. Breathing here, a couple deep breaths. Inhaling, coming up and over the body into our back bend and bringing our hands to namaste. That was very nice. A really great hip opening. Let's go on and just wiggle our legs out, wiggle our hips out. Feel a little freedom through the hips, through the legs. Just take a moment to do whatever you need to do to allow the body to feel fresh and open. Bringing our hands to the sides. A strong samasthiti once again. Roll your shoulders back. Stand strong. Stand strong in your samasthiti. Bring your hands to namaste. Inhaling, coming up and back. Exhaling and falling forward into a forward bend. We're on our eighth Surya Namaskar. Inhaling, bringing the left back. Exhaling, coming into our plank pose. We're staying in our plank here for a couple deep breaths, exploring the arm strength that it takes to stay in our plank. Comfortably breathing, and we're gonna roll into our side plank. Rolling your feet on top of one another. You can either look forward or up, whatever is comfortable with you. Make sure that the hip is not dropping. Whenever you're ready, rolling to the other side. You can either look forward or up. Again, make sure that the hip is not dropping. You want one straight line with the body. We're exploring the different variations of plank, regular plank pose, then the side planks. Coming back to our plank, down to the knees, forehead, chest, hands, knees and feet on the ground, Shashtanga Namaskar. Try to bring the buttocks even a little further into the air. The buttocks should be as high as they can. We're touching the body with 8 points, but we're still keeping the buttocks in the air. This is a form of front bend. And now coming up into Bhujangasana, which is our back bend. Whenever we go into these back bends, we try to keep the feet together. We've now come into our Makarasana, just the rest of the back for a moment. This is our crocodile pose. The feet are on the outsides of the mat, toes going in each direction, hands on the palms, elbows underneath the front of our body. Just resting here for a couple of deep breaths in our crocodile pose, our Makarasana. Bringing our feet back together, we're going to go into another back bend, preparing ourselves mentally, hands by the chest, inhaling, coming up. We're looking up towards the ceiling now. If you feel that you're slouching, try to bring the turtle head out of the turtle shell. And if you need to, you can always bend the arms. If you feel comfortable coming up straight, then you can come up straight. Look over your right shoulder. Triank Bhujangasana. We're looking over the right shoulder and then looking over the left. Really drop your shoulders. Allow the head to look in both directions. Now again, we're looking over the right shoulder, but now twisting the entire torso. Inhaling to the center, exhaling, looking over our left shoulder towards our left foot, twisting through the entire torso. Inhaling, going into our deepest Bhujangasana possible. Breathing, breathing, breathing. And then slowly, vertebrae by vertebrae, vertebrae by vertebrae, very slowly releasing ourselves onto the ground, finally with our forehead on the ground. Breathing, bringing our feet out to the side, bringing our elbows, palms underneath our head, back to our Makarasana, our crocodile pose. We can even kick our feet back and forth in our Makarasana. Whatever feels good for you, 1 foot at a time, both feet. You're just resting here, releasing any little bit of tension. Breathing deeply through our Makarasana variations, bringing the feet back together, bringing our hands to the sides once again. Tucking our toes and coming back into our Adho Mukha Svanasana. You can even walk your toes slightly in so that the heel is closer to touching the ground or touching the ground. Work through your fingertips. Push through the fingertips, not through the palms. Now let's bring our left foot forward into our Vanarasana. Exhale into our forward bend. Inhale, hands up and over the head. Exhale and release back to Namaste. Great job, everybody. We've studied a lot of the Surya Namaskar so far, and we're going to study a little bit more. Just knock any of that stress out of the body. In your neck, your head, your shoulders. Just move the body around as you need to, whatever feels good for you. Now, bringing our feet back together, preparing for our next round, bringing our hands to Namaste at the heart. Inhaling, coming up, dropping back, exhaling and falling forward. We're in a forward bend now. Inhaling, right foot back. Inhaling, looking up, exhaling, dropping into our plank. Inhale, exhale, Shastang Namaskar, 8 points touching. Inhaling into our Bhujangasana. We're staying here for a moment, breathing, breathing, breathing. Exhaling into our Adho Mukha Svanasana. We're bringing our toes slightly forward, opening up through the shoulders, pressing our fingertips into the ground. We can bring our feet and our hands even slightly towards each other if it helps to bring the heels onto the ground. We can even pedal our ankles. We're just pedaling our ankles back and forth, bringing our heels towards the ground each time. Let's say 7 or 10 times. Just pedaling the ankles, opening through the calves and the hamstrings. A couple more times. And finishing pedaling our ankles, bringing our heels both towards the ground, then separating the heels to shoulder width apart. We are moving into our Urdhva Mukha, Adho Mukha Svanasana, back and forth. This is called the two dogs. We're going back and forth between the upward facing and the downward facing dog. 10 times. We're really opening the back muscles through the spinal cord. Inhale as we come up, exhale as we come back. Inhale as we come up, exhale as we come back. Coming back to our downward facing dog, hips into the sky. Stay here for a couple more breaths. Bringing the feet together. Inhale, bringing our right foot forward into our Vanarasana. Exhaling, dropping into our forward bend. Inhaling, bringing the hands up and over the head. Exhaling, dropping back down for our 10th round of our Surya Namaskar. Inhaling, bringing the left foot back, looking up. Exhaling into our plank pose. Inhale, exhale, as we drop into a Shastang Namaskar. Inhale, as we come up into our Bhujangasana. Exhale, into our Adho Mukha Svanasana. We can walk slightly forward, trying to bring those heels into the ground, pelvis into the sky. We're staying here. We're breathing here. Inhale, left foot forward. Exhale, right foot forward, forward bend. We're separating our feet. We're placing our hands underneath the feet and opening through our shoulder blades, hinging through the hips, opening through the hamstrings, pulling ourselves down into Paddhahastasana. Placing our hands on the hips, inhaling, coming up, dropping back, exhaling and releasing. Bringing our hands back to Namaste. Breathing deeply. Let's face front again. We've done 10 rounds of Surya Namaskar. Let's just take a moment to breathe. Feet shoulder width apart. Hands fully open, breathing. Fully relaxed, Shitali Tadasana. This is a relaxed tree pose, opening your eyes once again. Now, after 10 rounds of Surya Namaskar, we'll do a couple of lying down asana. Let's stretch our hands up and over the head and extend through the heels. So we're extending through the heels, through the fingers, really opening our body, inhaling and opening through the heels to the fingertips, exhaling and relaxing. Inhaling from the heels to the fingertips. Exhale, relax. Bringing our knees towards the chest. Wrapping our hands around the knees. We're now in our Pavan Mukhasana, our wind releasing pose. Bring the knees a little closer to the chest. We're still having our head relaxed on the ground. We're allowing the lower back to drop out after 10 strong rounds of Surya Namaskar. Start by bringing our right leg straight into our Ekapada Pavan Mukhasana, our one-legged wind releasing pose. Staying here for a few more deep breaths. Placing the left hand on the left side, looking towards that left hand, dropping that left knee to the right, twisting the body open. We're twisting through the torso. Ekapada Parshva Pavan Mukhasana, our twisted one-legged wind releasing pose. You can even close your eyes here. You're trying to touch that left knee towards the ground, at the same time trying to keep that left shoulder on the ground. With gently closed eyes, you're breathing, inhaling, coming back up, back to our Ekapada Pavan Mukhasana, coming back into our Pavan Mukhasana, bringing our chin towards the knees for a breath or two. The full activity of the Pavan Mukhasana with the head off the ground. Breathing here for one more deep breath. Then, extending our left leg, bringing the knee towards the body, the right knee coming back towards the body, towards the chest, our left leg fully extended, a straight left leg. Long deep breaths in our Ekapada Pavan Mukhasana. We're starting to cool down a bit. We're bringing that right arm to the right leg to the left, trying to ground the right shoulder, looking over the right shoulder, and then gently closing our eyes into our Ekapada Parshva Pavan Mukhasana. Long deep breaths. Relax. Inhaling, bringing that right foot back towards the chest. Breathing here. Inhaling, bringing both legs up, bringing that knees, and start to rock and roll back and forth. You're just rocking back and forth, allowing any little bit of tension in the spine or in the back muscles to be relieved now. You can go back and forth in the spine. You can bring your shoulders up off the ground, chin towards the knees once again into our active Pavan Mukhasana. And then very gently bring the feet down towards the ground. Keep the knees bent. Adjust yourself to make yourself comfortable. Bring the feet together and drop the knees to both sides. We're now in our Supta Baddha Konasana. This is our relaxed butterfly pose. Chin is tucked gently towards the chest. Hands in a comfortable position, maybe on the inside of the thighs or even on the ground. Allow the hips to fully relax and open up. Long deep breaths here. You're moving into your relaxation poses. Allow the body to start relaxing. Breathe. Breathe deeply. Breathe deeply. A few more long deep breaths. Extend the breath. A few more long deep breaths. In our Supta Baddha Konasana. Bringing the feet and hands together. Bring your knees together. Keep the feet separated, shoulder width apart. Keep the hands on the lower belly, chin tucked towards the chest. Breathing in our Shantsarovarasana. That's our Lake of Peace pose. Long deep breaths. Our feet are shoulder width apart, but our knees are together. This is the counter pose to our Supta Baddha Konasana. A couple more long deep breaths. Breathe deeply. Six or seven long deep breaths in each of these relaxation poses. Now extend the left leg out through the heel. Extend the right leg out through the heel. Extend through the left. Extend through the right. And relax both legs. Left arm drop to the left. Right arm drop to the right. Tuck the chin in towards the chest. And relax the back into the mat. Release any bit of tension in the body. Breathe. You are now in your Shavasana, your corpse pose, as still as a corpse, allowing the body to fully melt down into the mat, fully relaxed, breathing in and breathing out, releasing any little bit of tension, long deep breaths. No hurry to get anywhere, just taking these couple of minutes for yourself. Long deep breaths. Allow yourself to fully relax into these last couple of breaths. Body fully relaxed. You're starting to come back. You're bringing your attention back to the breath. You're bringing your attention back to the body. Prepare yourself to come back from your Shavasana. Whenever you're ready, rolling on to the left side. Bringing our knees towards our chest, wrapping the right arm around the knees. You're now in your Garbhatritasana, like the baby in the cradle, like the fetus in the mother's womb. You're wrapped comfortably, safely. And with the strength of your arms, sitting up, finding that comfortable seated position, keeping your eyes closed, keeping your palms open, breathing deeply. Bring your chin parallel to the ground, hands in the namaste. And within your own heart or aloud, gently chant three omkar. After your third omkar, you can gently bring your hands together, creating friction between the hands, placing those warm hands onto the forehead, giving yourself a nice temple and forehead massage. Bring your hands in front of your face and gently open your eyes. Namaste, and have a wonderful day.